In May of 1978, then-President Jimmy Carter's national security advisor, Zbigniew Brzezinski, visited China as part of the normalization of relations between the two nations. Brzezinski is said to have been impressed, even awed, by Deng Xiaoping. 6 years later, Brzezinski arrived in China again, this time on behalf of the head of a delegation from the Strategic and International Study Center of Georgetown University. This time, he is said to have been shocked at what was, at the time, a bold new idea.
He knew Chairman Deng Xiaoping. And I remember Chairman
Deng Xiaoping. One country, two systems.
A young man sitting behind Deng Xiaoping translated one country, two systems to Brzezinski. Simple and clear. This unconventional idea immediately became the focus of worldwide media attention.
And I particularly remember one exchange.
Twenty-three years later, in the People's Republic of China U.S. Embassy in Washington, we met the translator. At that time, he was the 8th Ambassador Extraordinary and Plenipotentiary of China to the U.N. In August of 1945, Zhou Wenzhong was born in Zhejiang, Jiangsu Province. He spent his childhood in Shanghai.
From 初三开始，高一、高二、高三，每年都下乡，下乡帮着收麦子啊，或者是做其他的农活。
Zhou's father, who once worked in the financial services sector, had a good command of English, something that made an impression upon Zhou Wenzhong, and in 1963, Zhou Wenzhong entered the University of International Business and Economics.
我呢，对国际上的事情很关心，那么我记得当时报纸上它都有专栏嘛，所以我都把它们给剪下来，收集起来，这个关于这个。
In the 1960s, China and France, then under the presidency of Charles de Gaulle, established ambassadorial-level diplomatic relations, as did many countries in Asia, Africa, and Latin America. Soon, Italy, Austria, Belgium and Canada showed their intent to improve their relationship with China. It was with an eye to the changing world and to China's new role in it that the University of International Business and Economics established the Foreign Trade and English major, which it hoped would attract and cultivate future diplomats. 19-year-old Zhou Wenzhong transferred to this major. In 1968, the school planned to send Zhou abroad to study. The Cultural Revolution would, however, delay Zhou's study plans.
68年底呢，就离开学校了。那当时文革也都在高潮当中，所以外交部也好，中央有关部也好，没有一个部委是这个需要进人的。所以呢，当时也是总理周总理啊，他出于这个爱护人才吧，就是把北京地区的外语院校的学生统统集中起来。 然后送到唐山北客庄解放军农场进行劳动锻炼，连里的领导都是解放军。我们一百多人就要种一百多亩地水稻。我就是分到炊事班，我是炊事班班长，我也是搞不清楚为什么当时看中我叫我去做炊事班班长，做这么多人的饭。我们上海人，这个本来就不怎么吃面食，是吧？那么现在你不仅是要吃面食，而且要做出花样。
At this time, a girl lately returned from Sweden joined the cookhouse squad. She majored in English at the Beijing Broadcasting Institute. Her name is Xie Shuming.
哎，我负责主食，她负责副食。 所以因为平时接触比较多嘛，那么按规定的农场他也不许谈恋爱，那么但是因为接触多了嘛，反正就产生了感情。
This virtuous girl later became Zhou Wenzhong's wife. In 1970, she assumed